I'm 2 months and 16 days post-op now, and I'm a bit worried because some of grafts haven't fallen out. Hello, my name is Odin. I'm in a 2 month post-op now, and I'm a bit worried because some of the grafts, 60%, haven't fallen and there are still scabs around or crust-like. The thing is, every time I try to massage the area, the grafts stick to the crust and they fall together, but most of the time, the crust falls with a number of my native hair. My question is, why didn't my scab fall go 2 weeks after surgery? And why didn't my grafts fall off? Some of it, few, falls with crust and vigorous massaging. What should I do?
Thank you for your question. You're concerned that about 2 months after your hair transplant, you still have some scabbing and some variability in cleaning, and some of your own hairs are shedding, and you're certainly needing some guidance. Well, first of all, I would recommend that you speak to your doctor. And very often, it's not the doctor who is the only one who can guide you, but it's typically the staff. In our practice, we do a lot of hair restoration surgery, and we practice something called hair regeneration, which I will discuss momentarily. These little crusts and scabs are basically just a lot of the dead skin cells and the mucus and product of healing, and they literally do have to be properly scrubbed off. And usually what my assistants do and my hair technicians is they teach our patients to not be afraid to pick off the scabs at this stage of the game, especially because usually it's the scabbing and all of the crusting will disappear in a couple of weeks. So it's a matter of properly moisturizing with a good shampoo and being pretty aggressive about scrubbing. So I think that if you contact your doctor and speak to the staff, they may even offer to wash your hair. You know, in hair restoration procedures, sometimes patients are very squeamish about doing anything and they're afraid they're going to hurt their grafts. So I'll teach you a little bit about just the life cycle of a hair transplant. You see, when the hair is transplanted, there is going to be, at a certain point, a shutting down phase of the hair follicle. It's called shock loss. And in addition, the existing hairs may also experience shock loss. What that means is hair grows in a cycle, and understanding the cycles of anagen, which is the growing cycle of 3 to 5 years, catagen, which is the regressive phase, which is about 4 weeks, and then telogen, which is a shedding phase, where the hair appears to be falling out. And that's a normal process. Telogen lasts about 3 to 4 months. So in the beginning, you can, within the first few weeks, you can really appreciate the appearance of your hair and see the grafts and the existing hairs living side by side. And then within the first few months, there's often a fair amount of shedding such that you feel like you're going backwards. And then 3 to 6 months after that, you start to see growth at a level where you notice a real difference. Most of the time we tell our patients to wait it out. We watch and see what happens in a year. In my practice, we have had some success with a regenerative technology called extracellular matrix. I've been performing hair transplant surgery for over 10 years, and in the past 3 years, I have been in a leadership position in the application of new technology called extracellular matrix, originally designed for wound healing, that appears to help with the hair cycle, whether it's with transplant or without. So let me explain. The point of the wound healing is that when we do our hair transplants, our grafts appear to heal faster. They appear to have a shorter shedding phase, and they appear to grow faster than was typically seen in our practice prior to using this extracellular matrix. Now, in addition to that, we have had a tremendous amount of success with reversing the hair loss process, where the hairs go from thick to thinner and then eventually disappear. It appears that what we're doing is we're activating some stem cells, and specifically the progenitor cells, which have been seen in studies by the University of Pennsylvania to be diminished in the scalps of balding males. The process of hair loss and the process of formation of a hair is very complex, and it all comes down to cells and signals. So what we have seen in clinical practice is that thinning hairs get thicker with this hair regeneration technology. What we're doing is we're combining extracellular matrix with platelet-rich plasma, and we're applying it strategically in the form of injection, microneedling, as well as topically, in order to enhance our patients in two ways. One is to reverse their thinning hair, and two is to enhance their healing process with the hair restoration. Not to mention the donor strip area. When I harvest a donor strip of skin, I'm a board certified cosmetic surgeon. I can do a very good closure, but I have found that when I apply this technology, my closures look even better. The hairs literally grow through, and very often it's very hard to even see the area of the incision. So to go back to your original question about the scabbing and et cetera, it's about good hygiene and being not afraid of dislodging your grafts. Once the grafts are in, within a relatively short period, they're pretty stuck in. Like a few days beyond the surgery, you actually would physically need forceps and do something to really pull those grafts out. So you're not going to lose the root. In the telogen phase, the root of the hair, or the dermal papilla, stays in place and then wakes up and grows later on, but it's the shaft of the hair that falls out. So don't be shy about washing your hair and being relatively aggressive about scrubbing. And I think that once you get this clear, your condition will improve significantly, and you can look forward to the results of your hair transplant. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.